Victorious warriors win first, then go to war, while defeated warriors go to war first, then seek to win. Hello YouTube, this is Crizmaniac bringing you folks another Pokemon X and Y Wi-Fi battle, and this match is a UU match versus LeVon. Well, looking at both of our teams, it might as well be like a MU match or a mixed tier match, because LeVon brings really weird stuff, even to UU, into all matches actually. And I just brought my not so serious UU team right here because I knew this match was gonna be really wonky. And my team kinda sucks because like three Pokemon are weak twice, especially my wall core of physically defensive Crocodile and specially defensive Playdol. But anyways, this team is meant to be hyper-offensive, and it hit you really hard, and my MVP for this match is Mian Shao, as you will folks see. Anyways, looking at LeVon's team, he has pretty strange Pokemon like a Scyther and a Marowak to UU, and this should be a pretty good win for me if I play my cards right, if I don't mess up, and if LeVon doesn't make his Pokemon work, because if you bring lower tier stuff to a higher tier match, you'll have to make those lower tier Pokemon work out in your team. Even more so than like Pokemon in the same tier. Anyways, he leads off with his Amipom, as expected. I intimidated it, which is nice because it won't get as much damage as it would if it wasn't intimidated. And even his Ice Punch won't really do much to me because I'm a physically defensive Crocodile. I take only like 20% from that, but he freezes me, which really sucks, like in the second turn of the match. But this is exactly what LeVon needs to make his team work against my UU team, even though it's not that serious, because his team is at a disadvantage on paper with its lower rankings in the tiers and stuff. Anyways, I can't really do much after that, so I bring in my Dehaka, which is that thing from Prince of Persia, and that is my Upside Down Squid. I forgot that thing's name, damn it. Anyways, I could go for the superpower here on anything that he brings in, but I predict his Quifargus to come in because he still has a bulky physical defensive ghost on his team, and I go for that Night Slash, dealing lots of damage to his physically defensive wall, and I could go for a second Night Slash if I want to, because it deals a lot of damage to this thing. But I'm scared of Will-O-Wisp anyways, because Will-O-Wisp would really cripple my, what's it called? Malamar! That's the name! Damn! Yeah, so that's the name of my Pokemon. I knocked it out with a critical hit, so that really makes up for that freeze with my Crocodile earlier. So we basically traded our physical walls in that really weird set of plays, because I traded my physical wall of Crocodile off with a freeze, and his Quifargus is down with that Night Slash. Anyways, he goes for a knockoff on my Switch, and he redraws Shudder. He knocks off my item from my Noivern, which is fine, I don't really mind that. And in comes his Waka, his Marowak, and surprisingly, LeVon's Marowak takes his Hurricane extremely well. I know Noivern doesn't hit really hard, but Marowaks aren't known to be that specially defensive. I guess this guy has Assault Vest and Max HP or something, but he took very little from that. Anyways, I bring in my Claydol because I can wall this Marowak if he doesn't carry a super effective move against me. He goes for Double Edge, and it doesn't really do much as expected. He can't go for a 3 on me because I have Levitate, and it looks like I'm going to be comfortable here with my Claydol. I go for Ice Beam right here. He again doesn't take as much damage as I expected. I guess it's because I'm at a wall, not really a method of attack. But he goes for a knockoff right here, which really surprises me. I guess that's the kind of move that he would stay in and hit me with. But I can go for the second Ice Beam right here and knock his Marowak out. Psych! It doesn't get knocked out because this Marowak is really bulky. Wow. I guess Assault Vest on Marowak, which undoubtedly it is carrying at this point, is working because it survived all those hits and took down my Claydol. Anyways, I bring in my Houndoom right here. I won't survive a special attack from this bad boy. Look at that, with all those bones poking out of him. He looks so badass and stuff. And I'm gonna just flamethrower this Marowak down. And he got one bony Pokemon beat another bony Pokemon, I guess. Anyways, he brings an Electross, which is another one of LeVon's really strange Pokemon. I go for Flamethrower right here because why the heck not? I can just deal damage to this thing. And he goes for the Drain Punch. I'm like, whoa, Drain Punch, what the heck? And I guess that really works out for him because he has a crit and he gets all his HP back. So I'm like, wow, the damage I've got earlier with that Flamethrower really was for nothing, and my Houndoom is out of the game. So I'm like, okay, might as well just deal damage this thing before my Houndoom just gets taken down. And my Houndoom, he was really mad with that crit earlier, so he just retaliates back with a crit of its own, and my Houndoom gets taken out, but not without taking a lot of that, not Marowak, but Electros' health, which leaves it very vulnerable to the next Pokemon which I bring in, which is the star of this game, which is my Mien Shao Chan from 4th gen, or rather 5th gen, is here to wreck shop. I know he's gonna bring in his Sky Thru right here, predicting me to high jump kick, so I go for a Sub. And Sub with a Life Orb Mien Shao really works very well, because Mien Shao has Regenerator, and you can switch out if your health gets too low and get all your HP back, and you can just be fine with it. And it makes predicting easier, because you just Sub, and then he'll just take away your Sub, but you can retaliate back with a very hard-hitting move, like what I did right now, which smashes his Sky Thru, and I thankfully hit with my Stone Edge, and down goes Levon's Sky Thru, which only broke my air with my substitute this battle, basically. And it didn't really do much this battle. Anyways, it brings Arcum, my Noivern, on his Ambipom. He goes for a fake out, whatever. I can outspeed his Ambipom and knock it out with some sort of move. And Levon knows that, so he redraws Palms, his Ambipom. And then comes his next Pokemon, which is his Electros, just to sack it off to my any sort of move. I go for a Boom Burst, drop the base on any one of Levon's Pokemon, and down goes his Electros. And comes Palms again, just to get a fake out. And Levon's Ambipom would easily take down my Noivern if I stay in, because he is faster than me with his priority on fake out. Anyways, I bring in Yakuza, my Frozen Crocodile, hoping to thaw right here, at least. And I could take up any of Ambipom's hits, except for U-Turner. U-Turner really hurts, even though he's a minus one. But I could bring myself in right here. He predicts my switch really nicely, and he can get momentum in his favor right now with that U-Turn. And he brings in Slim, Levon Scrafty. And Levon, I dub him as the Boosting King, because Levon's playstyle on Pokemon is boosting up and sweeping you. And this is the part where I got really scared, because Levon's known for his use of boosting Pokemon, especially his Scrafty, and Scrafty really wrecks a team if it gets a couple boosts up and if you don't have Talonflame. And Talonflame is not here in UU, but he predicts my switch to Noivern very nicely, and he just takes me out with the Ice Punch, but I can high jump kick with my Mien Shao in return and knock out Slim, his Scrafty, and phew, that Scrafty is out of the way really fast because of my superior type fighting type Pokemon, which is Chan, my Mien Shao. He brings an Ambipom right here. He just wants to get off priority fake out on me, probably. I bring in Yakuza once again, just take a fake out as expected, and I really want to fall out. But more than that, I really want to get a minus one on this Ambipom, because Ambipoms could hit really hard with that Technician boost to a lot of their moves, especially with Power Up Punch and stuff. And I'm hoping he won't go for Power Up Punch right here, because I have a Pokemon that's weak to it, and my Crocodile would serve as perfect setup fodder for his Ambipom, but thankfully he doesn't have Power Up Punch. He goes for the U-turn right here, knocking out my Crocodile finally, and down goes my Physical Wall, but his Ambipom is slowly getting worn down with that Life Orb damage of his. But this is his last Pokemon. I'm just gonna smash him with a superpower from Malamar, which is Scarf, and down goes Ambipom, and that will be the game. So folks, use Mien Shao. Mien Shao is really good, especially my set, which is Regenerator with Life Orb, with Substitute, Stone Edge, Baton Pass, and High Jump Kick. So I hope you folks enjoyed this battle. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you did. And I'll see you folks next time!